What is up, ladies and gentlemen? This is Coral Stride here, and today we are playing Call of Duty World War II, the private beta. Honestly, I don't got really much to say besides that I am glad to see Call of Duty back in the World War II setting, because Call of Duty World War was actually my favorite of all the Call of Duties, honestly, because I liked how the style of the guns, I liked the history behind World War II, and honestly, it was just a fun game all in all. And to see it back again, I'm so excited, and I played a little bit of it, got kicked out one match, and actually lagged at the end of the one match, it kind of froze. There's some kinks in the private beta a little bit, that I had to do a little tweaking with my Wi-Fi too, because it was having a fit. So let's jump right into this. But yeah, I don't know why my Wi-Fi wouldn't do it, even though I have 5G on the damn thing, it wouldn't connect to the damn game for some reason. I was having little problems here and there. But all in all, we'll be able to get into her. Welcome, and thank you for participating in the Call of Duty World War II multiplayer beta. We are thrilled to give you the first opportunity to play what has been our focus and passion for the last 3 years. This private beta is just a small part of the full Call of Duty World War II multiplayer experience available at the worldwide release on November 3rd. Your time with the game is incredibly valuable, so please submit your feedback via Reddit, our beta survey, or via our social channels. Have fun, and we'll see you online. Sledgehammer Games.
This is headquarters. Your home away from home and the center of your time here off the front line. If you're not out there in the field, this is your place to advance your career. So gear up, train hard, and get to know your fellow soldiers. We're well supplied, but you've got a lot to learn. Every man and woman on this beach knows this was just the first step in pushing back the Germans. We're counting on you to help us push through to the Rhine.
I'm Captain John P. Andrews, and I'm here to recruit you to the U.S. Army Infantry. As infantrymen, you will experience more combat than any other branch in our multinational force. You will be the tip of the spear. For that reason, you'll receive individual skills training and be made fit to fight. The instruction you'll receive emphasizes individual rifle marksmanship and hand-to-hand combat, so you will be able to engage the enemy at any range. At longer engagement distances, you'll rely on your skills as infantry riflemen to destroy the enemy. Up close, you'll receive instructions on how to fight with the bayonet. Sweat in training saves blood in battle. As long as you have your brothers in arms and your rifle, you are unstoppable. And if something tries to stop you, show them what a bayonet can do to anything in the way. Let's get to work.
Welcome to the Airborne. We are the most well-trained, physically fit, and battle-ready unit in the U.S. Army. Being a Sky Soldier requires peak physical fitness, mental and emotional toughness, and unhesitating courage. It doesn't get any more dangerous than this. We're the first in the fight, and we're the last thing opposition wants to see. We are hunters from the sky. If you think you've got the guts, then gear up, get on board, and let's go kick some Axis ass.
Pay close attention. The sooner we get the introductions out of the way, the sooner we can get to blowing things up. My name is Major James Parks of the Royal British Armored Division. Our armored forces have one mission. And one mission only: engage and destroy the enemy. We specialize in direct combat with opposing armored forces, strong points, and fighting positions. And we're also frequently called upon to provide for direct fire support for our comrades in the infantry. A weapon that is issued in our branch down to the squad level is the light machine gun. As a member of the armored division, it will be your duty to clear the way for our brothers in arms. If we don't do our job, then they can't do theirs. We fight for king and country, but most of all, we fight for each other. It is an honor to be armored. Never forget that. Now, let's get started, shall we?
Welcome, soldiers, to the Canadian Mountain Division, the most elite unit in the entire Allied Armed Forces. If you want to run headlong into Axis strongholds, try the infantry. But if you want to make your shot count, then we have a place for you. You are the eyes of the unit. You take in everything. The whole world lives between your crosshairs. Find your vantage point and execute the mission. They can't hear us, they can't see us. By the time they detect us, it's too late. If you have a keen eye and a steady hand, if you have the patience to wait for the perfect shot, if you can quiet the world around you and do what needs to be done, then look nowhere else but the Mountain Division.
Attention! Welcome to the Resistance. We do not have the luxury of time as our enemies are closing in, so I will be brief. We are the pioneers of a new expeditionary force, specializing in sabotage and covert operations. We operate by night, raiding supply points for weapons and explosives, including the incendiary shotgun shells that spark flames, creating a hailstorm of fire that consume our enemies. If you want to join us, you must be willing to sacrifice everything for the good of your countrymen. We are the French Expeditionary Force. We are the fire that will burn down the Axis Empire to the ground. Vive la Résistance! Vive la France!
That was actually a beautiful introduction for all the things. And I'm just going to push to see the division rewards. These can be yours. Division skill, rifle bayonet. Division training, infantry. Division weapon, classified. Which each class probably has a unique weapon to unlock at the end. Which, like, for instance, I think the airborne would be probably like the MP40. Which I'll show you why. Division skill is an SMG suppressor, which you could take off and on during just anytime you want to, which is pretty cool. And you got division skill SLMG bipod, division training armored, and classified again. Sniper sharpshooter, which I don't know what that's for. Might be to hold the breath, maybe, I don't know. Division training mountain, and division weapon classified. And these guys get the incendiary rounds for their shotguns, which is pretty cool, actually. And yeah, I'm gonna pick airborne. Join division. And what I gotta do, copy division, set as headquarters soldier. Personalize, okay, paratrooper. Which this is probably gonna be the different skins you can probably wear. Yeah, uniforms. Where was the one? Where is it? Oh, here it is. Faces where you could change to male or female, which I'll pick this character. Calling card, I am going to pick this one. No man left behind, because that's more like my type of forte. And then I'm going to pick airborne, which is pretty cool. Clan tag, let me see, what do I want to put as a clan tag? I don't think I have a clan tag right at the bat, so I'm not gonna worry about the clan tag. So you know what? I might have something. Hold up. Can I put any of these things in here? Yes. No. See how that looks. Did I take? Yeah, it doesn't look too well. I don't know. I guess I could find a good one later on. But we got their score streaks here, which is recon aircraft, glide bomb, which is pretty much the predator missile, artillery barrage. Let's see, what's the other ones? Molotov cocktails, care package, paratroopers. You can actually play, bring down some AIs to help you kill some players here. Yeah, we're gonna. Actually, let's look at the guns too for you guys. Division. Go to here. For the rifles, which we can't pick anyways, I think, besides this one. is the M1941. It's just the shade and the color on it just looks brutal and looks badass. These are assault rifles, I'm guessing. And there's the M1 Grand, which is a pretty powerful weapon. The STG-44, which I see a lot of people using from every video I see, pretty much. The grease gun is one we're going to be using, because that's our forte, pretty much. The PPSH we got unlock, type 100. The PPSH is the Russian clothing for submachine gun, and the type 100 is the Japanese clothing for the submachine gun. Light machine guns, you got the Lewis, which looks like something you would have on like a propeller plane. MG-15. Looks like you just threw a pipe and a belt together. The Baron. I can't remember what that looks like. It looks like, I know it's from Call of Duty War at War, but I can't remember what the name was. Sniper Rifle Caravan, which looks pretty nice. You got the Commonwealth. Honestly, that name, the name of this gun and this gun should have been in Fallout, honestly. Shotgun Winchester 1897, which is pretty much a standard one. You got the M30 Luftwaffe Drilling, if I'm saying it right, which is pretty much the double barrel. The toggle action, which it looks like it's like almost like a smaller version of a musket or something. But yeah, we're going to be using the grease gun. We got secondaries here, which that's all we have right now. I can't really look at it. You got the tactical with the smoke grenade and the concussion. You got the grenade and the sticky. Let's see. Let's say take launcher as secondary and resupply it from enemies killed without explosions. A launcher. Enemy targets appear from farther away. Increase mini-map coverage. Resupply bullets from killed enemies and swap weapons faster. I'll go with that. You got all these different abilities that can make you do certain things, which is pretty cool. Airborne, I need to get tokens to unlock different tokens for these people, which ain't bad, which I will do. And you got attachments, of course. That could change anything, honestly. Honestly, let's get into the game. I think I kind of talked about the weapons and everything enough, so let's jump right into TDM. The matches I jumped in actually were just actually starting, which was nice. It wasn't games that were already in progress, like this one pretty much I think is. But whatever. I take what I get here. I'm not complaining. Win or lose, it's a beta, so I'm not really getting too butthurt about
Team
it.
Deathmatch. Eliminate all Axis forces.
All right, let's go.
Bring the war to them. Bring it hard.
Put my suppressor on.
Need another bandolier. I think he's down.
Okay, you're done. Got dolphin dive, which is kind of weird. Let's see if we can find some enemies here. Alright, one down. You're down. Let's go. At least I got the damn chitters a little bit. I just haven't played a damn Call of Duty game for how long? Been a good while. Let's see here.
Recon aircraft ready for mission.
Alright, good, good, good. Oh, shit, I got killed. Fuck. Alright.
Recon searching for targets.
Recon playing, go in. Do your job.
Mm-hmm.
Enemy down!
Shit. I had a feeling it was gonna happen. Damn it. See, I'm getting those damn chitters a little bit.
Recon flight concluded.
Forgot to change my sensitivity a little bit.
Recon searching for targets. Recon searching for targets.
I definitely gotta change my sensitivity or I'm gonna be screwed a little bit. Goddamn. Yeah, I gotta change it. Settings. Six. And we're good. Alright, here we go. I'm good now. Let's get in here now. Start ruining these people's days. Right, lucky it doesn't have like a long lasting thing on it. I just said if it had a long lasting thing, that would be absolute bullshit.
They're in the trail!
What the fucking trench gun. It's kind of creeping me the fuck out, dude.
Recon aloft. We have eyes in the sky.
Okay, good. Actually doing really well.
Searching for targets.
Keep on swapping positions like crazy. Fuck. Damn. Oh well. Finally find one and he just jumps right in my damn face. Guys will be behind me. Alright, come on, dude. Damn. I definitely gotta take this suppressor off.
He's on bomb mission underway.
Just not cutting it with this gun at least, because this gun barely has power to begin with. It's kinda a little bit of a pain in the ass to kill somebody. Alright, 75 to 30, we did pretty good. Bronze star. By the way, that is the red dot of that grease gun, which is kind of funny. It's a little, really small fucking red dot. I was at the bomb with 9 and 5 as kills. Not bad. Not bad at all. Like I said, this is, oh, I didn't want to do that. It's the only problem with, like I said, with, this is what happened the first time in the first game before. Because it kind of froze on me, and that's the only bad thing about it. It will, it freezes on you, and I don't know if that's a occurring thing that happens a lot, but happened to me twice already, so I don't know. Join the fight. But yeah, we're gonna find another match. Take a drink while this loads. But yeah, that was pretty good. A lot better than what I did in the other matches before. Like I said, I just gotta work out that. I don't know. A lot of people, like, in my opinion, I, like, probably won't understand, like, what, how. Like, with me, when the adrenaline starts pumping, my hands start to, jitter a lot, like, crazy. Because I'm, like, I don't know. Ow, sorry. It's just, like, a lot of shit's going on when the adrenaline's pumping, when I'm getting kills, trying to stay alive, not get shot in the back by a crazy asshole with a shotgun or whatever, but, I just got worked them out a little bit. Like I said, I haven't played a Call of Duty in a while. I mean, online, so. I played with bots on many occasions on Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare, because I just want to have a little fun and fuck around with bots, but nothing really too serious. Okay, yes, we know about that. So where are we at here? Did I get an attachment yet? I think yep, got a red dot sight. Or, they call it lens sight. Adds like a little miniature thing. As you can see, it looks just looks like a, they look like they put a bottle cap or something on the little iron sight, which is pretty funny. Let's see what else. Didn't level up yet. I got 2 tokens on it. Oh yeah, so I can unlock any of them that I want. I'm gonna probably unlock infantry. And I'm gonna unlock. And I'm gonna unlock mountain. But I want my airborne class. And I'll have infantry too. I don't have the M1 Grand yet, so that will do for now. Yeah, because the sniping, I don't know, because it seems like a lot of people are running around, so it's really selective if you're going to have to do sniping, because you probably have to just stay back and most of the time in your map, in your spawn, just pick people off. That's pretty much how you got to do it. But, yeah, let's go and find another match of TDM. Hopefully it's this match that hasn't started yet. I'm not complaining because we won, but... So far, like I said, I'm loving this game, though. Feels like the way Call of Duty War was, and feels so good. 41 potential games found, but yet not one of them can throw me in. Okay. Okay, well, this is doing its thing. Social, that's... Okay, we got match players, so that's good at least.
Oh, hello. Warm. Let's try.
Alright, we gotta toggle mute, of course.
So you get ranked up in the division as well, along with as also character.
Alright, we got a lot of people talking. but yeah. You see people changing their gear as they want to. And we also got people leaving, like always. So those people are, I guess, what the gold players are teamed up with each other. I don't know. Oh, yeah. So I guess the blue is with the blue. And, yeah, I don't really understand that. I guess that's just different players. Let me see. Can't actually see what the hell's going on here. Alright, okay, we got 2 of those green dudes, 2 of the orange, 2 yellows, so that signifies they're on teams. I'm gonna mute these guys, because I'm ahead of time. But at least we got the match starting, at least. Let's see what, oh, we got this map again. I don't know how many maps are actually in the beta at the point. I only seen so far this one, the snow map, and I know there's a different map for
team
the
match. Eliminate the enemy
war
team.
Game mode, which I'll play later. Honestly, I like that to play on that because it's a team objective match, and if you get players against regular people, it's kind of meh.
Advance and take position.
almost had him. Alright, I'm all the way over here apparently. God damn, these guys. I should be able to aim faster than them. Somebody's burning to death. We got corner campers with shotguns now. This should be interesting.
He coming!
If you're gonna be a shotgunner, at least run around. At least the trench area. I knew there was gonna probably be an after effect. Shit. Good lordy. That shit hurts. Seems like it's what everybody's using now. Yeah, at least I got the kill, at least. Yeah, that flame shotgun, like, damn. Even if you miss with it, it's like, it still overkills you. It's like hard to win against that damn thing. Like you said, like with that, he didn't even hit me and he caught me on fire and it's just like instant death. I think they might have to tweak that a little bit, because that's kind of... Yeah, I think they need to do a little patching with the shotgun though. That's a little much. So it's like you don't want to have to actually hit somebody with that damn thing and it catches people on fire. It's kind of annoying a little bit. Like, especially if they could constantly use the flame rounds. I mean, if it's like actually a kill streak you have to earn, like the flame rounds, and be able to go off like the fire, like how a flamethrower would have to earn the flamethrower and stuff.
In the radar,
you dropped the Johnny Dance
first.
Damn it. Alright, let's see what else.
On the
those guys. If he got killed or what? I'm confused a little bit here. Okay.
Well done, soldiers.
Alright, we won again. Allies. Listen, when it comes to the shotgun, if it's just straight a shotgun, I wouldn't mind it too much, but honestly, I think the flame rounds should be like a kill streak or something. Or something you actually have to earn on the gun or something, like get so many kills and you start using the flame rounds, because I think they're a little too much, in my opinion. So you can say you could be the most redundant person and shoot like a mile away and catch somebody play on fire with that shit. But I don't know, like I said, I haven't used it, so we have to see how that works. But yeah. I don't know why it keeps on freezing like that, because I know it did it again, but I'm probably going to end it here, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like I said, it's always appreciated if you leave a like and subscribe for more. And I'll see you awesome people in the next part. Peace.